round three of the MotoGP World Championship under the bright sunshine, about to get underway. 11th fastest. He will start from that fourth row of the grid alongside his countryman, Bradley Smith. It's Scott Redding.
Guys, I'm just going to bring you very quickly down to Yamaha once again with Massimo Marigali this time. Maya, we've just found out Mark is going to be running with the hard tyre. We know from the tyre sheet that you guys have chosen the extra hard. Are you still confident with that choice?
Yeah, on the Yamaha works better the extra hard. The hard one was moving quite a lot after a few laps. And yeah, we are convinced that this could be the right choice.
Thank you very much, Mario.
There you go. One thing, just keep an eye on Cal Crutchley, if you would, Dylan, because he was contemplating the choice as well. That may just make him make up his mind if he sees that Marc Márquez in front of him on the grid has done that. 5 minutes to go. Safety car leaves the grid. 25 laps of this 4.806 kilometre, 2.986 mile Termas de Rio Hondo circuit. It's an absolute cracking circuit. One of the fastest on the Grand Prix calendar. Fast and flowing, I think, sums it up perfectly.
Yeah, those great fast left-handers at turn 6 and turn 11. What a performance this weekend by that man, Eugene Laverty, 14th on the grid. Easily his best Premier Class qualifying result so far. At one stage, we thought he was going to advance into QP2, but Laverty, top open Honda rider on the grid this afternoon at qualifying, actually. Hiroshi Oyama, who's on the factory Honda, of course, replacing Danny Pedrosa.
Here we go. Front tyre hard, medium hard, extra hard, but there we go. Cal Crutchlow also has followed Marc Márquez and gone for hard rather than extra hard rear tyre.
Márquez and Cal Crutchlow, Nick, both came to the grid with the extra hard fitted. They've changed to the red banded harder option on the line.
So it's round three, the MotoGP World Championship. Confirmation. Márquez hard rear tyre, not extra hard. Aleix Espargaró and Andrea Iannone have no choice. They've taken the hardest option they can take. So keep an eye on things with Crutchlow and Márquez as we come into what those last five laps of a grueling 25-lap race. Front row of the grid. Andrea Iannone on that front row for the first time this season. In the middle of the front row, the Suzuki of Aleix Espargaró. But in pole position for the second successive race and for the second successive time in Argentina, world champion Marc Márquez. So welcome back to Argentina. I'm Nick Harris, sitting alongside me, Matt Burt, down in pit lane, Dylan Gray. Round three, the MotoGP World Championship.
Front row, Marc Márquez, the reigning world champion. Aleix Espargaró and Andrea Iannone. Second row, Cal Crutchlow, Jorge Lorenzo and Andrea Dovizioso, one of the Ducati GP15.
Third row of the grid, Danilo Petrucci, Valentino Rossi Championship leader and Maverick Viñales. Row four, Bradley Smith, Scott Redding and Hector Barbera.
Colombian Yoni Hernandez heads up row five. Laverty 14th, Iama 15th, then Bradl, Abraham and Pol Espargaró way down 18th on row six.
Row seven, Alvaro Bautista crashed out here last year. Nicky Hayden and Jack Miller, Loris Baz, Mike Domeglio, Marco Melandri, and completing the grid, the man from San Marino, Alex De Angelis. Grid being cleared. Márquez 5 points behind Rossi in the championship. A race victory would give him the lead in the championship.
The big news is, Nick, at the start of this 25 lap race, Marc Márquez has gone for the hard option tyre. We know all four Yamahas, they're on the extra hard rear tyre. So fascinating to see how this, the early part of this race unfolds. Just over 50,000 fans packed in to this Termas de Rio Hondo circuit.
Dylan, final talk about the weather. We can see sunshine from the commentary box.
Yeah, the sun has now come out. As we know, when it does come out here, it is absolutely baking hot. Track probably won't be quite so hot because, as you know, as we say, it's only just come out. It's been cloudy so far. So it'll be very interesting to see, if it does stay out, how the track temperature might rise throughout. And especially now that we have this extra little game with the different tyre compounds.
Do you think it's a gamble for Honda to do what they've done?
No, I don't think so, because it looks like they weren't getting an awful lot of extra pace with the extra hard tyres, so they may as well try and use that hard, maybe even run away a bit, you know, try and create a gap and then try and manage it. Obviously, towards the end of the race, it's going to be very hard to tell, but they are, you know, they are quality riders. They should be able to manage it. What's going to be more fascinating is that, obviously, the likes of Suzuki and Ducati have the same tyre.
So it's round three of the MotoGP World Championship. We're at the Termas de Rio Hondo circuit here in Argentina. Sun is beaming down. Rear tyre choice is very interesting indeed. Valentino Rossi leads that championship by a single point. Have they taken a big gamble, Marc Marquez and Cal Crutchlow, by going for the extra hard rear tyre and not taking, sorry, the hard rear tyre and not taking the extra hard option? We will find out in the next 25 laps. Good afternoon to you. I'm Nick Harris, sitting alongside me, Matt Bird, down in pit lane, Dylan Gray.
Five riders on the extra hard. Rossi, Lorenzo Smith, Paul Espargaro and Scott Redding, the only one of the four Hondas to go for the extra hard tyre. Marquez and Crutchlow, they changed on the grid to the harder option.
Magnificent qualifying performance by Aleix Espargaro on the Suzuki in the middle of that front row. So here we go. We're at Termas de Rio Hondo in Argentina. Round three of the MotoGP World Championship. And what a start by Marquez and Espargaro.
Espargaro currently running in first place up the inside of Marquez. Bad start by Andrea Eno, and he's back down to about sixth or seventh. Espargaro got away well on the Suzuki. He leads Marc Marquez. Valentino Rossi bumped out a bit at turn two. There's Cal Crutchlow on the LCR Honda with Andrea Dovizioso right behind him. It's Marc Marquez now leads that turn two. Espargaro dives straight back up the inside.
Espargaro leads away through turn three. This is the fastest part of the circuit, 1 kilometre long. So they come down towards turn five. A Suzuki leads a Grand Prix race, perhaps not for long. The extra horsepower of the Honda just races past. Marquez will try and break them up very early on because of his tyre choice.
Lorenzo, aggressive move up the inside of Cal Crutchlow at turn five. Lorenzo up into third place and rides around the outside of Espargaro at turn six. Lorenzo leading the chase of Marc Marquez. We said it was a bad start for Ian Unni. He's been bumped back from third to sixth.
Yeah, I think that Lorenzo realises as well that he's got to be careful. Pressure from Cal Crutchlow there on Andrea Dovizioso. Lorenzo knows that Marquez would try and get away, but Aleix Espargaro fights back once again, then runs it a little bit wide. So they come down now into turn 11. Marquez is getting away at the front.
Lorenzo back underneath Espargaro at turn 11. Marquez already trying to make a break. 0.3 seconds up he was through the first three sectors. Espargaro again up the inside of Lorenzo. This is down at turn 13. Runs it a little bit wide. Lorenzo back into second. End of the first lap. Marquez leads. Lorenzo, Espargaro, Crutchlow, Dovizioso, and Ian Unni is your top six.
So Marquez just where he wanted to be with that tyre choice. He's opening up an advantage. 0.8 seconds already as they fight it out through turn one. But they're fighting it out for second place.
Valentino Rossi was started eighth. He's in eighth place at the end of the first lap. No big move from the 36-year-old at the moment. It's Marquez that leads on this second lap. Marquez already a second clear of the field. Lorenzo leading from Aleix Espargaro. Cal Crutchlow now. Honda power against Suzuki power. Crutchlow should win that race down to turn five.
Here we go into turn five. He certainly does. Espargaro doesn't want to let him through. Espargaro now round the outside. He's got pushed wide. Espargaro. So Crutchlow now moves up into third place.
Espargaro really pushed out wide at turn five. That gave Andrea Dovizioso the chance to move up into fourth place. Lorenzo still in second. Crutchlow has moved up one place on the grid into third. It's now Ian Unni having a look up the inside of Espargaro. Espargaro led the race on the first lap. He's already been dropped back down to sixth.
Yeah, he's been pushed back by the two factory Ducatis, by Crutchlow. Marquez still leads the way comfortably. Lorenzo's now got a bit of clear space to settle into some sort of rhythm. Great start by Crutchlow. Didn't make such a good start in Austin, but from the second row of the grid, super start by the British rider. But Marquez won here last year. He's winning here But this race may be decided in the last five laps.
Crutchlow just had a lunge up the inside of Lorenzo at turn 13. Was he able to make it stick? Crutchlow now across the line. He was. Marquez leads the way, but Cal Crutchlow has taken over second place from Jorge Lorenzo. Lorenzo now under attack from Dovizioso at the first corner. Lorenzo loses another place.
Yeah, Lorenzo relegated now to fourth place. And he's coming under pressure, enormous pressure from Andrea Iannone. New record from Marc Marquez. He knew what he had to do, and he has done it from pole position.
Interesting, all those riders around Jorge Lorenzo have got the softer tyre than the Spaniard is currently running. Lorenzo, the only one at the moment inside the top six that's got the extra hard tyre on. Marquez making a big break at the front already, 1.6 seconds clear of Cal Crutchlow as Valentino Rossi makes a move up the inside of Aleix Espargaró at turn five. Espargaró now back down in seventh place.
Yeah, dropping back through the field. There is Valentino Rossi. He has, you can see from the band on his tyre, gone from that extra hard rear tyre choice. One would think, and Yamaha are hoping, it will be an advantage in the latter stages of the race.
Marquez from Cal Crutchlow on his first competitive ride here at the Termaster Rio Hondo circuit, doing a great job in second place. Crutchlow looking for his first podium finish since the Motorland Aragon race last September. He was on board the Ducati, but Marquez, 1.6 seconds clear he was at the start of this third lap. He stretched that lead out now to almost 2 seconds over Crutchlow, coming under pressure from the Ducati GP15s of Dovizioso and Iannone.
Could be up to 2 seconds when they cross the line, and there'll still be 22 laps to go. Here is Crutchlow. The gap now is 1.955, almost 2 seconds. Crutchlow, Dovizioso, Iannone, Lorenzo, Rossi, then a little bit of a gap, that early race leader, Aleix Espargaró. Great ride again from Petrucci and Yonny Hernandez. Bradley Smith moving up into 10th place, Scott Redding into 11th, Maverick Viñales dropping back to 12th. Another poor start from Paul Espargaró, Stefan Bradland, Hector Barbera in 15th, and Jack Miller in 16th, Eugene Lafferty 17th.
Marc Marquez just goes through your screen there in the lead. There's Andrea Iannone, started from the front row of the grid for the first time this season, but made a bad start, dropped back to sixth. He's recovered up to fourth place. He's got Jorge Lorenzo and Valentino Rossi behind him. Lorenzo now coming under pressure from Rossi. This is at turn five. They'll pick it up, get on the fat part of the tyre, accelerate hard left now through turn six, fourth gear. Lorenzo still in fifth place. There's Marquez going through turn seven.
Yeah, through seven and eight, plus two Crutchlow. That's exactly right. That's what they're telling Marc Marquez. The sun glinting off that familiar number 93 as he comes up the incline through nine and 10. Then they flick it left, and he's very fast, turn 11. He wants to break the field very quickly and very early on. That's what he's done, because he is slightly worried, slightly, I think, being the right word, about how his rear tyre will be when it comes towards the end of the race. He's building up the sort of advantage so that it probably won't matter.
Yeah, he's going to cross the line to complete lap four, Nick, probably with a 2.5 second lead over Cal Crutchlow. This is the aerial view of the battle for second. It is indeed a 2.5 second lead for Marc Marquez on lap five. Crutchlow still holding second from Andrea Dovizioso and Andrea Iannone. Rossi still trying to get by Jorge Lorenzo for fifth place.
Would you expect, Dylan, for the Yamahas with that extra hard option to come strong towards the end of the race, because it's all the just hard option people in front of them?
I think you certainly would. I think the main problem is they need to make sure that they manage that tyre, because you also don't know how the guys are going to be managing the hard. It also depends on what's going to happen with track temperature. Last year, towards the end of the race, there was some what they call blistering in the tyres. Now, obviously, Bridgestone would have worked to make sure that doesn't happen, but, of course, it's very, very tough under a race situation, but you would certainly think that the Yamahas would have an advantage. You just don't know at which point that's going to kick in. It might be too late.
Well, almost too late for Valentino Rossi. He's trying to get past Jorge Lorenzo, but he is not finding it easy.
Well, think of the difference between those guys is Lorenzo is on the medium front, Rossi on the hard front. So you'd imagine Rossi will definitely try and do so under the brakes. He should have a small advantage there.
That's exactly what he's been trying to do. You've got to say, Lorenzo's rode pretty robustly in front of him, not to let him through.
He had a little look up the inside of Lorenzo at turn five in the braking zone. This is the flick through turn 11. Lorenzo still holding fifth place. Rossi really closing up though through that fast left-hander. Will Rossi have a look up the inside now at turn 12? Maybe a little bit too far back to attack on this lap. He is indeed.
Yeah, there's no way he's going to be the flick it left now through 14. They come over actually the start and finish over the finish line, actually still cranked over. 20 laps to go here in Argentina. Marc Márquez clearing off at the front, but there is just a little doubt, and a little doubt it is about rear tyre choice. We'll only find out when we get into those grey areas, perhaps with five laps remaining. In the meantime, he is just going to open up a bigger and bigger advantage at the front as we ride with Rossi, with Lorenzo in front of him.
This is Valentino Rossi in sixth place now, accelerating through turn four. All the way up to sixth gear, about 210 miles an hour. All the way down this back straight. Jorge Lorenzo, his teammate, in front of him. It's Cal Crutchlow in second place at the moment, keeping those two Ducatis at bay right now. Dovizioso, Crutchlow runs it a little bit wide though in turn five, gave the opportunity for Dovizioso to close right back up as they flick it left through six.
Rossi all over the rear wheel of Lorenzo, but not able to get through yet. Just a little mistake there from Crutchlow, and it did bring the two Ducatis, as you can see, Dovizioso and Iannone closer. Here comes Rossi. This time Rossi is through at turn seven.
Valentino Rossi, you can see they're already having big movement on the rear tyres, on the extra hard Bridgestone rear tyre, of course. All of the riders in front of him are on the hard option. That's the softer option. So Rossi finally through on Jorge Lorenzo now. Next in his sights is Andrea Iannone, who's currently running in fourth.
Down towards turns 12 and 13. Crutchlow second. There's Dovizioso and Iannone. So the two Ducatis hounding the Honda. Márquez, well, he's crossed the line already. Let's see what the advantage is. 3.2 seconds already, and we still have 19 laps remaining.
Crutchlow, Dovizioso, Iannone, Aleix Espargaró's dropped back off that lead group. Down in seventh place is the Spaniard.
Yeah, it's a difficult decision, this tyre choice. And further down the field, it's paying off as well. Bradley Smith is starting to make a vote, and we have major problems here for Petrucci or Hernandez.
That's Johnny Hernandez. You can see there, that bike of his, that Ducati, is on fire. He had no idea, Johnny Hernandez, as he tipped it through that fast turn three. He'll have to jump off that as quickly as he can. He had no idea, did Hernandez, that his bike was on fire. Started smoking as he came out of turn one, and then he went through turn three. We could see flames pouring out of the belly pan of that Pramac Ducati, and Hernandez doing the right thing, jumping off, getting off the racing line. It's going to be interesting to see if there's been any oil dropped through that first sector by Hernandez.
That is the worry, isn't it? What caused that? Is there any oil being dropped? And he had to abandon the bike quickly. He didn't want to, but he had to. Look at that gap progression for Marc Márquez. It's an enormous lead. Right, let's have a look at things once again. This is Crutchlow. There is Dovizioso. There is Iannone. Again, Crutchlow just runs it a tiny tad bit wide. And there, obviously, is fire extinguisher on the Pramac Ducati of Johnny Hernandez.
Marc Márquez across the line now. He'll be going through the first corner. This is where Johnny Hernandez's Ducati engine let go. So we'll hope, fingers crossed, that there's no oil been dropped on the track. This is Cal Crutchlow going through the second corner. We ride on board with Andrea Dovizioso. Márquez in front of him, just going through that first, second corner. You can see Crutchlow runs it a little bit wide at turn two. Has that let Dovizioso come through? It certainly has. Crutchlow drops back a place into third.
He's had a few problems, hasn't he, in the last couple of laps, Cal Crutchlow. Can't believe that's tyre problems already, but Dovizioso is past him. There is Márquez backing it into five. Then we have Dovizioso, Crutchlow, closing up all the time on Andrea Iannone is Valentino Rossi. Then we have Lorenzo, Aleix Espargaró, Bradley Smith up into eighth, Petrucci ninth, and Paul Espargaró in 10th. Redding, Bradle, Vinales, Jack Miller, some points for him in 14th. Hector Barbera in 15th place. Hayden, Baz, Lafferty, De Meglio, Uyama in 20th. Batista, Abraham, Melandri, and De Angelis. One man out, Johnny Hernandez, with the Ducati on fire.
Just saw a replay there of Cal Crutchlow. Just running in a bit too hot at the second corner. That let Andrea Dovizioso
move up into second place. Thankfully, all the riders got through the first sector without any problem, so no lubricant dropped on the circuit, hopefully by Yonny Hernandez's Pramac Ducati. It was a spectacular mechanical failure. Flames pouring out the side of that belly pan, as we saw, but it's Dovizioso now in second place. 3.5 seconds back, though, of Marc Márquez as they come through the final corner.
Yeah, Crutchlow nice and tight. Rossi ready to make a move on Iannone. Up towards turn one they come. Crutchlow very close on Dovizioso. Still in third place. We ride, I would imagine, with Andrea Iannone. That's Crutchlow and Dovizioso in front of him. Be ready for a Yamaha to nip into picture any moment now, with Rossi just tipped in behind the front row starter, Andrea Iannone. So Ducati second. He's been second in those opening two Grand Prix, Andrea Dovizioso.
Yeah, this is that second group running for second place. Dovizioso, Crutchlow, Iannone and Rossi. And they've dropped Jorge Lorenzo off the back in sixth place. Lorenzo now 1.8 seconds behind Valentino Rossi. Lost 0.8 of a second to the Italian on the eighth lap, so Lorenzo struggling to stay in touch with this second group.
And guys, are some of the guys from Bridgestone just pointed out, look at Rossi's lap time. He's now actually even quicker than Marquez the last couple of laps.
Wow, Rossi moves in front of Andrea Iannone. This might look done and dusted with a 4-second advantage of Marquez, but tyre choice, clear bit of road for Valentino Rossi. Who knows, there's still a long, long way to go. This could have an incredible ending, this race.
Valentino Rossi, we know, has got the extra hard rear Bridgestone tyre on, so durability, you would think, would be much better with his rear tyre than those in front of him. Marc Márquez, Andrea Dovizioso, Cal Crutchlow, all running the hard option rear. Here we are riding on board with Dovizioso through the final corner. Cal Crutchlow right behind him. Rossi just moved into fourth, as we know, by Iannone. The run down to the first corner. Rossi now really close up on the back wheel of Cal Crutchlow. Rossi, surely he'll pounce soon on Cal Crutchlow and relegate the British rider off the podium.
Will he ever go at turn five at the end of that long back straight? They're through through two, up to three, and then to four. Dovizioso onto the back straight, open up the horsepower of that Ducati. Here is Crutchlow, Rossi right behind him. Rossi may have a nibble here. We ride with Valentino Rossi. Here is Crutchlow. They come down towards turn five. Don't think he's quite close enough. Brilliant onboard stuff as we switch back, riding with Crutchlow to Rossi. But that number 46 is bang in his face, but not past him.
Only two riders on the last lap in the 139s. One, Marc Márquez, who's 4 seconds clear at the front of this race. The other one, Valentino Rossi, number 46, the 9 times world champion, having a good look at Cal Crutchlow. Big moment for Crutchlow. That's going through turn seven. He loses one place to Rossi. Crutchlow almost down at turn seven. He drops back to fourth. Rossi now inside the top three.
Rossi up into third place. Crutchlow now coming under pressure from Andrea Iannone. He's having a few problems, Crutchlow. I don't know if it is tyre problems. Let's have a look at this one.
You can just see there, Crutchlow, well, he was well wide onto the dirty part of the track. That's why he nearly went down on the LCR Honda.
Yeah, but also think, guys, that harder tyre, when it's, the softer tyre, when it drops off, it's going to start moving around an awful lot more. And we've seen that kind of stuff doesn't really bother Marc Márquez, but a lot of other riders can get unsettled, especially in the braking zone. So that I think, is our first time that the tyre might be dropping, so we certainly need to keep an eye out on Marc Márquez's times as well.
But do you think that's a bit early for that, Dylan?
No, not at all. We say when it's dropping, it doesn't necessarily mean it's going to keep dropping at the same rate, but I think we've seen it use up, let's say, the best part of its grip.
Marc Márquez, though, Dylan, still the quickest rider on the track. The grip not going away as yet for the Spaniard. On lap 11, he was the only rider on the previous lap to remain in the 139s as Valentino Rossi now closes up on Andrea Dovizioso. This is down at turn five. Big moment on the last lap for Cal Crutchlow at turn seven, and he's now almost about to lose another place, is he, to Andrea Iannone through turn six.
You know, he haven't got up the inside. I don't know if he's made it stick. No, Crutchlow, I think, just hanging in there. Here comes Rossi at turn seven. Rossi into second place in front of Dovizioso.
This is where Rossi took third from Cal Crutchlow on the previous lap up the inside of Andrea Dovizioso. Now Rossi, 4.3 seconds behind Marc Márquez with 15 laps to go. We know that Rossi's got the extra hard Bridgestone rear tyre on. He should keep grip for longer as the race distance goes on. There is Marc Márquez, number 93.
As Dylan so well pointed out, they're telling him it's Rossi in second place now. Then he can, but he can ride the bike a little bit loose and slipping and sliding around. Probably nobody better in the world than Marc Márquez.
We're just chatting with the Bridgestone guys again, so they've just confirmed that essentially you start off with a lot of grip, then you've got quite a steep drop, and then it stays relatively gradual. One thing they said, which happened in the last race, was that they could see those drop-offs, but that now, at the moment, most riders will be in what they call like a managing phase, so they're going to try and manage the tyre as best as they can, because the fastest lap times last year came in at the end, so they do try and keep something in reserve should they need to push.
That surely has got to be in favour of the championship leader, Valentino Rossi. It is a big, big gap, 4.1 seconds, but he has made, well, the correct tyre choice for him, certainly, as Dovizioso tries to close up on him at turn five. Here is Márquez. He will just keep ploughing on at the front. Made the decision on the grid to take the hard rear tyre rather than the extra hard rear tyre, which suggests everything is fine here, but it may go off towards the end of the race. Will it affect him like it affects most people? Probably not.
Probably not at all, Nick. This is Márquez up through turn nine. Cal Crutchlow has dropped back down to fifth. Andrea Iannone on the last lap made a pass to move into fourth place. Bradley Smith coming through the field. He was running in 10th a few laps ago. He's passed the Espargaro brothers to move into 7th. Alessio Espargaro, of course, started on the second row of the grid. He's in 8th.
Yeah, made a great start, Alessio Espargaro. He's in the middle of that front row, number 41. Him and Márquez really did contest turn one. Look, Alessio Espargaro led the way. A good start also by Crutchlow, as you can see, from that second row of the grid. But it was the Suzuki that led the way.
This is on board with Jorge Lorenzo off the line. Valentino Rossi's sweeping to the outside of the track. There's Bradley Smith and Andrea Iannone, who dropped back from the front row of the grid. It looked like Rossi might have got a nudge in the first corner. He did. It was from Andrea Iannone. We could clearly see earlier on in the race that Rossi got a little bit of a tap going through turn one. That would have cost him probably a couple of places. We look at a replay through the final corner of Cal Crutchlow leading Dovizioso, Iannone, Jorge Lorenzo and Valentino Rossi. That's all changed now. There is the race leader, Marc Márquez. This is 13 laps to go into turn five. The gap still just over 4 seconds.
Super to watch him through turn five into this sweeping turn six. 12 and a half laps to go. He won the race here last year. He bided his time. It's a different race. He only took the lead, I think, on lap 17 after being down in sixth place. Then was a comfortable winner. Dovizioso is not letting Rossi get away in their battle. What a battle they had for second place in Austin just a week ago.
The gap on the last lap between Márquez and Rossi, just 6 thousandths of a second. Andrea Dovizioso now, he's dropped back into the 139s. He was 1/10 of a second slower than Valentino Rossi, so he's not letting his compatriot run away in second place. There's Márquez now coming down into turn 12. This is the final, this is the penultimate corner. This is 13. Márquez there at the bottom of your screen coming through turn 14. Now let's have a look at the gap as he comes over to start lap 14. Márquez, 4 seconds clear of Rossi. So Rossi not really making any impression.
He's not, but he's not increasing it at the moment, is he? Which, and if everything we're told by Bridgestone and Dylan getting all the information down there, the pendulum will swing a little bit in Rossi's favour towards the end of the race.
There's Pol Espargaro, good ride from the Spaniard because he started way down in 18th place. He's fought his way back into the top 10 in 9th, chasing down his brother Aleix on the factory Suzuki, who's currently running in 8th. This is the battle for 11th with Danilo Petrucci, Maverick Viñales and Stefan Bradl.
There'll be some points for Stefan Bradl. That'll be welcome for the German, of course, on his third ride for the forward racing Yamaha team after switching from the LCR Honda team.
There's actually a good battle between Bradl, Barbara Jack Miller and Nicky Hayden for top open class honours. That's going on behind Maverick Vinales in 12th. Here's Valentino Rossi, currently running in second place. Picked up a couple of tenths of a second on this lap through the first sector. The advantage down to 3.8 seconds.
Yeah, this is going to be crucial. We're going to be looking at those lap times so, so carefully, just to see if Valentino Rossi has got any sort of an advantage. It could be an amazing end to the race. Yeah, let's have a look. It is coming down, Matt. It is coming down.
We're getting into the stage of the race where that extra hard tyre should be really coming to Valentino Rossi. You can see on the front there, he's got that red banded hard option front. Marquez now has crossed the line to finish lap 14. Rossi over the line now, the gap down to 3.7 seconds.
Just be interesting because they've just told Marquez what is happening. I mean, 3.7 is still a mighty big gap, but they've told him he's starting to close. Let's see what he's got now. Really, really push on to try and open it up again. It's going to be a fascinating last 11 laps.
Andrea Dovizioso keeps the pressure on Valentino Rossi, the number four on the factory Ducati. He's just set his best lap of the race so far, a 1:39.660. There he is, right behind Valentino Rossi on the back straight. The two Italians have dropped Andrea Iannone and certainly dropped Cal Crutchlow out of podium contention at the moment. Jorge Lorenzo way down in sixth place and 2.2 seconds back of Crutchlow in fifth.
This is Marquez into turn six. What a replay again from Marc Marquez. This is 14, I think, isn't it? Coming into the finishing straight, corner speed 150 kilometers an hour. But Marquez, he can face any situation, but it's not the easiest situations for him here, knowing that he's got to push on as hard as he possibly can, but just slightly worried. And Rossi now is beginning to lap considerably quicker than him, isn't he?
Marquez just dropped into the 140s there. You can see on that graphic on lap 14, Rossi running consistently in the 139s. Last lap was a 1:39.687. That's what helped him claw back those 0.3 seconds on Marquez. Marquez over the line now to start lap 16. The gap down to 3.4 seconds. Rossi's taken another 0.3 out of Marquez.
There may be little Marquez can do, because if he pushes too hard, he may find himself in major problems. But if anybody can handle this situation, he can. And he looks like a man that really is on a mission at the moment, through two, up towards three and four. Keep an eye on those lap times. Rossi is on the charge, and he has a better choice of rear tyre as the race goes on and on.
Marquez now down into the braking zone for turn five. Rossi just opening up a bit of a gap now on Andrea Dovizioso in third. Iannone remains in fourth. Cal Crutchlow fifth. Best lap of the race so far from Jorge Lorenzo as he tries to cut the gap back to Crutchlow. This is Rossi now going through turn six. The gap now through the first two splits down again to 3.1 seconds. Rossi edging ever closer to Marc Marquez.
Oh, what a race this is going to be. 9.5 laps to go. Looked like it was done and dusted for Marquez. Rossi is clawing back the advantage, and he should have the advantage with that extra hard rear tyre. The gap again is, well, actually, he's just pulled back a tenth of a second there, Marc Marquez, but let's wait and see when they cross the line. Rossi's certainly gotten him in his sights now. Dovizioso hanging on there in third place. Wonder what the board is going to tell Valentino Rossi.
Lap 16 completed for Marc Marquez. He's over the line now. Rossi comes over as well. 3 seconds is the lead. Valentino Rossi takes another 0.3 seconds out of Marc Marquez. Now, what Marquez could be doing here, he knows he built up an advantage of over 4 seconds, so he might have just backed off slightly to try and manage his rear tyre, nurse it home to the finish. He has still got 3 seconds with 9 laps to go, so Marquez might just have eased off his pace a fraction, just to, as we say, try and preserve the grip of that rear tyre, Nick.
He must have realised what the situation may be right from the word go, and that's why he went out so quickly. And it still is a big gap, 3 seconds, but Rossi, when he's on the charge like this, knowing he's got that advantage of that extra hard rear tyre, can't speak highly enough about Andrea Dovizioso, and Cal Crutchlow has got back in front of Andrea Iannone.
Yeah, we're going to see that move by Crutchlow. This is down on the brakes into turn 12. Crutchlow up the inside of Iannone. So Crutchlow back into fourth place, and Jorge Lorenzo catching that battle for fourth.
Yeah, he's come back really strongly, Crutchlow. So Iannone, I think he was worried about the tyres at the end of the race, he was telling us yesterday. But here we are, Marquez. Front tyre hard, rear tyre hard. Valentino Rossi, the big, big difference is their rear tyres. One on a hard, one on an extra hard. And you would think, logically, that the extra hard will last the race distance longer.
And don't forget, Marc Marquez did come to the grid for this 25-lap race with the extra hard fitted to his Repsol Honda. He changed on the grid to the hard option. Marquez, well, he took a 10th back on Valentino Rossi on that lap. So you do wonder if he did just ease off for a couple of laps just to try and save a bit of grip on that tyre. Remains as it is now. Marc Marquez and Valentino Rossi will head to the first European round of the World Championship in Jerez in 2 weeks' time, level on points in the World Championship.
Marquez would be the official leader after winning two races. He may have managed this race quite brilliantly. And I'll tell you what, we're going to find out in the next couple of laps if that is the case, as they come down towards turn five with 7.5 laps remaining.
Good first sector on lap 18 by Valentino Rossi. You can see on that graphic there, the gap down by 0.4 of a second, from 3.127 seconds to 2.748. So Rossi good through the first sector with that extra hard rear tyre.
He's put back another 10th through the third sector. These are crucial, these are graphics coming up. Absolutely crucial, because it just will give us an indication as if Marquez is having to slow with the tyres, if he's been looking after the tyres. And Rossi, obviously very fast, very consistent, very confident in that rear tyre. Here we go, he's getting closer.
Rossi, another 0.2 of a second quicker through the third sector. Edging ever closer to Marc Marquez. It was only 3 or 4 laps ago. The gap was 4.1 seconds. Rossi has recovered 1.7 seconds as Marc Marquez crosses the line now to finish lap 18. The gap down to 2.314 seconds. Rossi has just set a personal best lap of the race, a 1:39.399. He was almost a full second quicker than Marquez.
Dylan, our tyre man. It looks like it's happening, doesn't
it? Exactly. This is exactly what Bridgestone were predicting. They said the tyre's going to drop off that hard a lot more. The thing is, will he have anything in reserve? He might be waiting to see whether Rossi can catch up or not. That would be the clever thing to do. But, you know, this was a gamble which Marquez took. They knew exactly, and he knew exactly, he had to run out. He had to build that gap because they would catch up at the end. Maybe they're a bit surprised as to how quick Valentino's catching up.
Rossi is catching him all the time. It's coming down to almost 2 seconds now. There's those top speeds, but Rossi is closing. There's still 6.5 laps to go. Marquez must know now that the championship leader is closing all the time. That is the gap. They're down at 7 and 8. We've almost forgotten what's happening behind them. There is Crutchlow. You know, he's coming under pressure from Lorenzo. Smith, 7th. Aleix Espargaró, 8th. Pol Espargaró, 9th. Redding, 10th. Vinales, Petrucci, Barbara, Miller and Bradle are your point scorers.
Lorenzo having a big moment coming through turn 5. Trying to fight his way by Andrea Iannone for 5th place. Cal Crutchlow still hanging on to 4th. Here's the race leader, Marc Marquez. This is through turn 13. Let's keep an eye on the gap. Valentino Rossi there, just coming through your shot. Marquez over the line now.
What is the gap going to be? Cross the line, 2 seconds. 2 seconds between Marquez and Rossi. 6 laps to go.
And Valentino Rossi, Nick, is dragging Andrea Dovizioso back into this fight as well. Rossi across the line with the best lap of the race for him so far, as was Andrea Dovizioso. Dovizioso less than a second behind Valentino Rossi. 6 laps to go of the Termaster Rio Hondo circuit. Marquez coming under intense pressure, his lead down to under 2 seconds. Rossi has found nearly 0.3 again through the first sector. The lead, 1.7 seconds.
They race down towards turn 5. Marquez on the brakes. Rossi, that familiar big right leg goes out. It's a masterclass of riding by the master of Grand Prix racing. But catching him and then passing him may not be so easy. Dylan, is Marquez keeping something in reserve, or is he just having to ride as hard as he dares?
Well, I'm still down here with the Bridgestone guys. They're saying they're not entirely sure, because if he is pushing, then that's actually going to be very bad for him, because the tyre's just going to drop off more and more. The thing he should be doing now is try and keep it as smooth as possible, because at least then when Rossi does catch up, then he might have a bit more in reserve. So it's more him who's got to keep a calm head. But, you know, this is exactly the kind of situation that they were predicting beforehand.
This lead is being slashed now by Valentino Rossi. It's down to less than 1.5 of a second. There will be five laps to go when they cross the line. Rossi is going to be with him pretty quickly.
Has the gamble by Marc Marquez backfired? Rossi over the line, a new lap record from the Italian in 1:39.019. His fans cheer him on in the grandstands. Rossi now within 1.2 seconds of Marc Marquez, and this is where he's so strong through that first sector. Rossi has dropped Andrea Dovizioso. It looks like it's going to be a shootout for the victory between Marquez and that man there on the charge, Valentino Rossi.
36-year-old. He's riding like an 18-year-old on a track bike, isn't he? Amazing stuff from Rossi. There's nothing Marquez can do at the moment. He made the choice of that hard rear tyre. Rossi said right from the word go he was going to go from the extra hard. He's got him in his sights. When is he going to have the first nibble at him? Knowing Rossi, he will go at him as soon as he possibly can.
Rossi found another 10 through the first sector on this lap, 21. That's Marc Marquez ahead of him as they plunge down the short downhill to turn 7. Marquez now pitches it right, going through 7 and 8. Rossi, what a ride. Well, we said he started 8th on the grid and won in Phillip Island, and he started 8th in Qatar and won. He's putting up a pretty good fight to make it 3 in a row.
He certainly is.
Guys, looking at the data from last race, with roughly 5 laps to a go, this was the point when the guys on wearing tyres started to say, look, now I know how far it is to the end. Sorry, well, they know that anyway, but now they know that it's not so long, and we might see some of them start pushing. So let's keep an eye on Marc Marquez, whether there comes this point where he, say, pulls the trigger and says, now I don't have much left, now I can really burn the tyres up.
Marquez will not give this up without an enormous fight. You know that. 4 laps ago, Rossi in second place. The gap now, 1.157 seconds. Be interesting through that second split just to see the gap. He's got him in his sights. He's not quite close enough. You've got a glimpse there. Dovizioso, Crutchlow, Iannone, Lorenzo, Smith, and Aleix Espargaró.
Just a quick shot there. Marquez's crew chief, Santi Hernandez, checking the track temperature. Is that hard option rear tyre going to hold out for the victory? 4 laps to go. Valentino Rossi powers down the back straight. The gap now, 6 tenths of a second on the brakes into turn 5. Rossi as close as he's been all race.
Rossi's got him in his sights. There's the track temperatures all the way around. It's a lot hotter than it has been for the day so far. And it's getting late. It's coming up to 5 o'clock in the afternoon here. The sun has only really come up in the last couple of hours. Marquez made the choice of using the hard rear tyre, not the extra hard. Rossi, from the word go, said he was going to use the extra hard. Who has made the right decision? 3.5 laps will tell us.
Through turn 11, Marc Marquez. Valentino Rossi has taken another tenth of a second out of the double world champion. Half a second now, the gap. Rossi almost right with Marquez as they come to complete lap 22.
Through the right-hander, flick it left over the start line. 3 laps to go and an amazing Grand Prix of Argentina here at the Termas de Rio Hondo circuit, up towards turn 1. Rossi chasing his second Grand Prix victory of the season, as is Marquez. Rossi closing all the time.
Unbelievable performance by the 9 times world champion through the second corner. Marquez having big moments, that rear tyre twitching as he gets on the gas. Rossi now, this is through turns 3 and 4. Rossi right with Marquez now as they power down the back straight.
Will he have a go first time? I don't think he's going to be quite close enough. We ride with Rossi. Marquez in front of him as they come down towards turn 5. He likes 7 and 8, also Rossi, for overtaking.
Marquez now, this is through turn five, runs it over the curb on the inside. Valentino Rossi now within 0.3 of a second of the Spaniard.
Seconds don't matter anymore now, it's visual. You can see Rossi closes up down at turn seven.
What a recovery by Valentino Rossi. He said all along that he needed to race that extra hard rear tire. Marquez gambled, he rolled the dice on the grid. He came to the grid with that extra hard optional. We thought he was gonna race it. He switched at the last minute to that red banded hard option tire. Has that been his crucial mistake? Two and a half laps to go. Rossi now right with Marquez.
Down at 12 and 13. When they cross the line, there will be two laps to go. Marquez can probably hear Rossi closing up on him. Rossi does close on 13, flick it through 14. Two laps to go with this extraordinary Grand Prix of Argentina. They race up to turn one, here comes Rossi.
Marquez holds the lead going through the first corner. Valentino Rossi hugging his back wheel. Rossi so quick through this first sector. Will he have a look on the inside at turn two? Rossi moves to the inside. Rossi's going to take the lead. Rossi up the inside of Marquez, runs it a little bit wide. Marquez back through at turn two.
We knew he wouldn't give up without a big fight. Marquez back in front. Rossi closes once again through three and four. Can he get a slipstream and try and get out of the slipstream on the brakes into turn five? Here we go. 93 against 46. Rossi on the brakes.
Rossi up the inside. Marquez had a bit of a moment on the brakes going into turn five. Rossi leads contact there between Marquez and Rossi. Marquez is down. Marquez has crashed out of second place in the Argentinian Grand Prix. Well, they touched on the exit of turn five. And as Marquez and Rossi went to flick into turn six, Marquez clipped the back of Rossi and the world champion is down.
No points for Marc Marquez. A touch. Coming out of turn five with 1.5 laps to go. Marc Marquez, race is over. Rossi surely now will win the Grand Prix of Argentina to increase his lead in the World Championship.
Listen to the crowd. What a remarkable last couple of laps we've seen. What a remarkable 23 laps we've seen here in Argentina. Valentino Rossi crosses the line to start the final lap.
He actually clipped the rear wheel, didn't he, of Rossi. Rossi into turn one, past the Rossi grandstand. Andrea Dovizioso, another second place. There is going to be an investigation by race direction on that incident.
A dejected Marc Marquez walks away. This is the moment of the race. Marquez running a little bit too hot on the brakes. Rossi up the inside. And there's going to be contact here. Marquez is going to clip the back of Rossi. Well, that was almost a carbon copy of the Zarco Simeon incident, I think, in Texas. Rossi was going for the line through turn six. Here we go.
I really don't think Valentino Rossi can take the blame for that incident, do you? We will find out. Mike Webb and Race Direction will decide that. In the meantime, let's celebrate an amazing, truly amazing ride by the 36-year-old Italian.
Marc Marquez at one stage was over 4 seconds clear of the field in this 25-lap Turmaster Rio Hondo race. What drama we've seen unfold in the last 40 minutes or so. Confirmation on your screens, Race Direction. The incident between number 93, Marc Marquez, and number 46, Valentino Rossi, currently under investigation. Rossi, for me, was in front of Marc Marquez. So Valentino, he did have a little glimpse left.
Here we go, into turn 12, 13, one bend to go. His second Grand Prix victory of the season for the master, the doctor, Valentino Rossi.
Andrea Dovizioso crosses the line to take yet another second place. And Cal Crutchlow dives up the inside of Andrea Iannone to take the final place on the podium. Crutchlow loved that, didn't he? Crutchlow takes third with the best lap of the race for him on the final lap. Lorenzo crosses the line in fifth. But Valentino Rossi, what a victory. Aleix Espargaró comes across the line in seventh place.
Whew. It could be a long night. Under investigation by Race Direction. I've got to say, they made a very quick decision, didn't they? Last time out, Maverick Vinales is absolutely furious. Scott Redding finishing ninth place. It's a good ride by Scott Redding. right, let's just sort out the positions and then worry about what's going to happen. Rossi wins, Dovizioso second, Crutchlow third, then Iannone Lorenzo, Bradley Smith, Lacey Spargo, Paul Espargaro, Scott Redding, Maverick Vinales, Danilo Petrucci. Great point scoring ride by Jack Miller.
This is the key moment of the race. Contact there between Rossi and Marquez as they exited turn five. And you could clearly see that Rossi was ahead of Marc Marquez when they collided on that run through that to turn six. Marquez scampers back to his bike. He could not get it going again, though. That's when Marquez tried to flick it left at six and hit the rear of Valentino Rossi's factory Yamaha.
I don't want to take sides, but Marc Marquez is involved in those incidents the other way around many times, isn't he?
Well, he's really angry with himself, Marc Marquez. He took the gamble to run that hard option rear tyre. Valentino Rossi at one stage was well over 5 seconds back in that race. But the old warhorse, he loves a battle, doesn't he, Valentino Rossi? A second win of the season for the 36-year-old. And with Marc Marquez scoring no points, what a boost for Valentino Rossi's championship challenge.
His 110th Grand Prix victory. He won in Argentina back in 1998 when he won the 250cc race in Buenos Aires.
He's won a few dramatic races in the 109 wins before that, but few would have been as dramatic as that one. Credit to Andrea Dovizioso, a third successive second place for the Italian. He becomes the first Ducati rider ever to score a podium finish in the first three rounds of the season. What a final lap by Cal Crutchlow. His best lap of the race, securing him a first.
Right, sorry to butt in. No further action will be taken after the incident between Marc Marquez and Valentino Rossi. End of the matter. Rossi is the winner.
There you can see on that graphic running across the bottom of your screen the incident between Marc Marquez and Valentino Rossi. No further action from race direction. Deemed a racing incident. Pretty much what we thought, Nick. Almost identical, I think, to what we saw with Zarco and Simeon in Austin a few days ago. Crutchlow, jubilation for the British rider. And his teammate, Jack Miller, the best open class rider. Double joy for CWM LCR Honda. Miller crossing the line in 12th place, just beating Hector Barbera. But what a day for number 46, Valentino Rossi.
Where will this end? Where will this story, where will this adventure, where will this career end? An extraordinary ride. We saw in Qatar where he could fight it out, with Andrea Dovizioso throughout the race. Here, he just pulled back the advantage, knowing he had the advantage. And in the end, he forced Marc Marquez into a massive, big mistake. Extraordinary ride by the 36-year-old Italian. His 110th Grand Prix victory.
I'd love to know who writes Valentino Rossi's scripts, because you could not make it up. He looked dead and buried in the first half of that race as he struggled in the early part with that extra hard tyre. But Bridgestone always did feel that in the second half of the race, as the grip went away, that would be a good tyre selection. Marquez's gamble, of course, he switched on the grid. He came to the grid with the extra hard on and he changed in it at the last minute to the hard. And it proved to be the wrong choice, Nick.
I don't know where to start telling somebody about that race. I must admit, when he built up such a big advantage, tyre choice and everything else, I thought nobody is going to catch Marquez. He looked so happy at the front. And then we just saw those lap times of Rossi, didn't we? They measured out to start with, and then we saw him just start making his way through. Great move by Cal Crutchlow on Andrea Iannone. And he just by a whisker took his first podium of the season.
Brilliant stuff from Crutchlow. His first podium of the season, his first since the Motorland Aragon race last September, and he loved that. Look at his celebrations as he crossed the line. But all the headlines, once again, will be taken by those two. Valentino Rossi, joyous in Parc Fermé. Marc Marquez, disconsolate as he heads back into the Repsol Honda garage. As we saw earlier on, race direction looked at the incident on the penultimate lap between Rossi and Marquez, deemed a racing incident. Confirmation there of the championship standings. Rossi, 66 out of 75 points. What a start for the Italian 2015. And Marc Márquez now down in fifth, trailing Rossi, Nick, by 30 points.
You wouldn't have believed it, would you, going into that first race in Qatar? What was that, 4 weeks ago? But Rossi has won two of those races. Dovizioso has finished second in all three. Crutchlow's put the LTR Honda there. And Marc Márquez is 30 points, yes, 30 points down on Valentino Rossi in the championship. A championship he has dominated for the last 2 years.
41 and a half minutes of pure adrenaline-fueled action in MotoGP.
Yeah, absolutely.
Absolutely fantastic race. Cal Crutchlow goes over to congratulate Valentino Rossi. I'm sure he's just explaining how he made that move on Andrea Ian. And here's the major incident of the race, the collision between Valentino Rossi and Marc Márquez. That was on the penultimate lap.
When you see it from that angle, there is absolutely no argument, is there? There was a bit of a coming together before then, wasn't there? But
yeah, Rossi had a quick glance to his right because there was contact. Márquez had rubbed his front wheel against against Rossi. As we can hear now from Cal Crutchlow, third on the CWM LCR Honda. What a ride by the British rider.
Well, Cal, you're back on the podium again, just the third race, and considering the moments you had and that dramatic last stab up the corner, must be one of your best podiums.
Yeah, obviously, it was quite a tough race with plus zero on the pit board all the time. I made some mistakes and lost the group to Valentino and Dovi in one lap, really. But I was happy with the pace. We did a good job all weekend, and we took a gamble with the tyre, the same as Mark, and it paid off, I think, because we had a better corner entry. With the harder, I don't think we would have been able to last with the Honda. So a great job by CWM, LCR Honda. They've done a fantastic job all weekend. We've worked hard, and we've worked hard for this podium, you know. I'd like to thank the people that wrote me off, and I would like to thank the team for the third place.
Thank you very much, Cal.
Well done, Cal Crutchlow. Here we are, Andrea Dovizioso. 3 second places in 2015.
Well, Dobby, you didn't get to use the extra hard, but even the hard tyre seemed to work well. At the end, did you think you might be able to catch Valentino?
No, he was alpha tens faster than me. I pushed really hard to try to stay with him, but in some corners I lose more than one tenth, and it was enough to I couldn't stay with him. But I'm really happy. We struggled a lot this weekend, also in this track, the bike worked very well. Thank you to the team, thank you to the Ducati and all the people working at home.
Thanks, Dovi.
What a start to the season for Andrea Dovizioso, but he'll make all the headlines once again. His 110th Grand Prix victory, Valentino Rossi.
Well, Valentino, I think you said Qatar was one of your best races. How do you describe this one? First catching up, then the incident with Mark.
I'm sorry for the incident with Mark, but I feel him touch me before in the center of the corner and after another time. And I'm very sorry for him that he's crashed. I hope that he's okay. But it's a great race. I'm very happy. You know, I had the pace. I know that I have to push. Mark was far, but I know that he decided for the red tire. So I try to stay concentrated, to ride always at 100%. And the bike was great. I'm so happy. Two victories already, and I think that we can fight to the end.
Thank you very much, Vado. Congratulations.
Extraordinary.
I think he's quite happy with that, don't
yeah,
you, Nick?
Yeah. Just to confirm that Marc Márquez is all right. He stomped away from that incident. Probably, as you so rightly said at the time, more angry with himself than anything else. He's been involved in those incidents before. It's a long way to come here. It's a difficult place to get to. When you see the enthusiasm and the excitement, and then you get a race like that, it's worth that 13-hour journey home tomorrow, isn't it?
Action-packed all the way through that 25-lap race. Drama on the penultimate lap, that collision between Valentino Rossi and Marc Márquez. Márquez, let's not forget, he did lead this race by over 4 seconds before he deteriorating grip on that hard option rear tyre that he chose. It was a gamble this time that did not pay off for the double MotoGP world champion.
An extraordinary race. There was Qatar when we had that great battle with Dovizioso and Rossi. This was such a different type of race, but the tension as he's starting to close it up. You just had to look at the times, and we were getting the graphics on the screen. Every set turn you could see he was pulling back, pulling back. And it came very obvious with about five laps ago he was going to catch him. Just a question of getting past him. And then the drama of the crash. Whoa. You can get better than that in any other motorsport, bring it on, because that was fantastic.
You have to say, Nick, Marc Márquez was a lap and a half away from that hard option rear tyre choice being a masterstroke. Mm-hmm. He did hold the lead until the fifth corner on the penultimate lap when he collided with Valentino Rossi. That will be the major talking point of the race, but take nothing away from Valentino Rossi, because it was another masterclass from the 36-year-old Italian. Andrea Iannone just missed out on his second podium finish in MotoGP. A great fight right to the end with Cal Crutchlow, but Crutchlow with that brave move at the penultimate corner, taking third from Iannone.
What was interesting that Cal Crutchlow also went with that hard option rather than extra, and he made it very clear that it paid off for him. There'll be some celebrating tonight, I can tell you, with Valentino Rossi and the team, and why not? 110 Grand Prix victories. How many is Agostini's? Always thought he was way, way out of touch with Agostini's.
But he'll be looking over his shoulder.
He will. Old Aggo will be back home there, won't he? And thinking, what is going on? Oh, he's wearing the Argentinian football shirt as well. He's always got it just right, hasn't he?
I'm sure it's a Maradona shirt. We know that Valentino Rossi and Diego Maradona, the Argentinian football legend, all right, fairly close. Diego Maradona came to the Misano Grand Prix a few years ago, didn't he?
Caused a bit of a stir, didn't it? Caused a bit of a stir. Yeah, he certainly did. Valentino Rossi, 110 Grand Prix victories. His second of the season. He leads the World Championship by 6 points. 36 years old. There you go. Carl Crutchley wanted to wear a Coventry City shirt, but they didn't know they didn't know who they were down here in Termas de Rio Hondo. Well done, everybody. That was another classic MotoGP encounter. It just gets better and better, doesn't it?
Valentino Rossi climbs onto the top step of the podium for the 110th time in his career. Mayo Merigali about to receive the Constructor Trophy.
Well, it's interesting, we heard from him before the start of the race, didn't we? And he made it quite clear that Yamaha had decided a long time ago they were going to go with that extra hard option, and it paid off.
Ever since Friday morning, Nick.
I remember Rossi saying it, yeah, and he said, I don't particularly like it, but we're going to do it and we're going to work our way around. And we said at the time, they will work their way around it.
Brilliant third place from Cal Crutchlow. The eighth Premier Class podium of his career. Great final corner move on Andrea Iannone. Joy for Lucio Cecinello's LCR Honda squad.
Great day for British racing, isn't it? Crutchlow third, Smith sixth, and Redding ninth.
We'll be getting used to these runners-up trophies with Andrea Dovizioso. That's the third one he's collected in three races so far in 2015. He pushed Valentino Rossi so hard for much of that race.
Yeah, Rossi didn't drop him, did he, when he got into second place? But all the headlines would be about the man wearing the Maradona Argentinian football shirt, Valentino Rossi. His 110th Grand Prix victory. At 36 years old, he leads the World Championship by 6 precious points. The Doctor still on top of the game at 36 years old.
It's been an excellent 7 days for Rossi. As we're about to hear the Italian national anthem.
Because